What you hear, and let it be yes we do. Oh Lord, we adore thee. Oh God, we lift your name on high. We exalt you tonight, oh yes we do. We
Amen. It's good to bring some folk. Let us now receive Middlesex, our third area vice moderator, the Reverend Timothy Johnson. Amen. Jordan. Amen. Timothy Jordan, God bless you. And now Middlesex Central Baptist Association. Can we now, on this night of our 118th annual session, welcome with a round of applause and thanks to the Lord, our moderator, the Reverend Dr. Derek R. Dumas. Amen. Amen. It's at this time now we turn worship service over to the hands of our worship leader, the Reverend Robert Peterson.
Putting our hands together for all of these great preachers. Come on, let's put our hands together and give the Lord the praise that he's worthy of. For this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Come on, open your mouth and give him praise. He woke you up this morning, started you on your way. He's kept you all day long in spite of the rain, in spite of the storm. Our God is yet worthy of praise. I don't know about you, but I'm ecstatic to be here on tonight to celebrate 118 years of God sustaining the ministry of our association. I promised some folks a little while ago that I would be on Express. So I'm getting on the A train. Let us all come together to sing our congregational hymn, Lift Him Up. The masters, men of them, Jesus. Put your hands together and give Him awesome praise. It is Him that we came to lift up on tonight. That being said, the Bible says men ought to always pray and faint not. We're going to move and ask our Pastor Joseph Brickhouse to come and offer up our prayer of invocation.
Let us pray. Oh God, our God, how excellent is Thy name in all the earth, the creator of every good and perfect gift. God, we come today just to say thank you. Thank you for keeping us up until this appointed time. Now, God, as we get ready to go further in this worship experience, God, we roll out the red carpet for you to do what you do best, and that show up and be God. God, have your way in this place. God, if there's any spirit that's not like you, God, we bind it now, God, that you can have your way. God, we pray, God, that you would take complete control right now. God, we cancel every foul spirit in this place. We cancel stingy praise right now. God, have your way in this place. God, touch the man of God that's going to bring forth the word of God. Anoint him from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet, God. God, open our hearts and our minds to receive what you're going to say through your manservant. And God, after all is said and done, we're going to give you honor and glory. God, we pray now, God, that you're glorified. We pray that Jesus is magnified. But most of all, God, we pray that these your people will be edified. These all blessings we ask in the mighty, marvelous, matchless name of the Messiah, the Lord Jesus, we pray. Let every heart say amen. festival tonight.
It's through the word of God that we find our instruction. Our scripture on tonight will be coming from John, the 17th chapter, verses 20 through 21. We're going to ask Pastor Ryan Buckland, the Tabernacle Baptist Church, to come and lead us in our scripture reading.
Gospel of John in the 17th chapter, beginning at verse 20, reading from the NIV version, said, "My prayer is not for them alone, but I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one. Father, just as you are in me, I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me." The gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen. 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 Amen.
We are moving. We are moving. You may take your seats in the presence of the Lord. And for the first time in our association, we're blessed with this music ministry. So let us sit. Come on, you ought to put your hands together and give God praise. Let us sit and enjoy, but not get so comfortable that you don't worship.
My everything, my everything, my everything.
how befitting it is that the pastor, the host pastor, would come and address us. So we now ask our pastor, Conway Johnson, to come and to address the house.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. It is a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Thankful to God for this opportunity. It has been, I believe, 9 years since we have had the opportunity to host the Middlesex Central Baptist Association. And so we're thankful to God tonight, to our moderator, Pastor Dumas and Mrs. Dumas, to all of our leaders in our association, those of you who make up the congregation tonight. It's good to be here. Yes, good to be here. The weather is not what we may have wanted, but God knows what he's doing. And so it is my honor and privilege to welcome you to one of my most favorite places in the whole wide world, and that is the beautiful, marvelous, miraculous, outstanding Sharon Baptist Church, 25 Howard Street, New Brunswick, New Jersey. And as God has blessed us to be here, we want to say to you, welcome, 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 and thank God for you. Pastor Gerald Smith is not here today. Moderator wanted me to report the events that took place for Christian Education yesterday. It was spectacular. It was spectacular. You know, after these many years in ministry, crowds don't move me anymore. And I believe God has specific people at specific places for specific times. And though there wasn't a great crowd, there was a great crowd in spirit. And so I want to salute him on behalf of our association and all of the participants who were there yesterday. One of the questions, and I can't remember, it was a list of things that we as believers were not able to eat. And as we listened to, I was getting ready to ring my bell, and I'm glad I didn't. And I'm glad I didn't. But one of the good people of the First Baptist Church of Linden buzzed their bell. But the Lord nevertheless blessed in a marvelous way. And so let us put our hands together for our brother in all of his work and all of his efforts he has done.
Bless the Lord. It's time for us to prepare our minds and our hearts to get ready to receive the word of God. And how befitting it is for our first vice moderator to come and to prepare our hearts and our minds to receive our moderator. So I pray that you hear ye him, the pastor of the St. John Baptist Church, in the person of Reverend Sean Wallace.
Amen. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. Songwriter said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be in the service one more time. He did not have to let us live, but I'm so glad that he did. Amen, 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 amen. We stand and give honor to God. We thank our moderator and his lovely wife for being here with us tonight. And we thank God for Pastor Conway Johnson and his lovely wife for opening up their doors. Sisters and brothers, I've been tasked with introducing someone who needs no introduction. In fact, the songwriter said, may the works I've done speak for me. For the past 4 years, as the moderator of this association, the works that he has done has spoken for him. For the past 12 plus years, as the pastor of the First Baptist Church of Linden, New Jersey, the works that he has done has spoken for him. For the many years as a preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the works that he has done have spoken for him. And just in case you don't know, Reverend Dr. Derek Dumas is the Lord's preacher. He's a scholar who can rightly divide the word of truth. He's an expositor who can reason between cause and effect. He's a competent leader. He's a skilled communicator. He's a critical thinker. He's a man of vision. He's a husband of one wife. He's a father of children, and he's a grandfather. And Dr. Dumas is God's man for such a time as this. The age-old question was asked, is there any word from the Lord? And I've come to report tonight, no, there's not just any word, but there is a word from the Lord. We don't need just any word, because just any word won't do. But we need a specific word for a specific people who are committed and commissioned to do a specific work. We need a word to challenge the status quo. We need a prophetic word that speaks truth to power. We need a word for a dying world about a living Savior. We need a word from the Lord. Just one word from the Lord will move all doubts, and the sun will shine. Give us peace of mind. Speak, Lord. Speak now. Tonight we shall receive that word from this on this 118th annual session of the Middlesex Central Baptist Association from our moderator, the Reverend Dr. Derek Dumas. After the next selection of the choir and the offering, hear ye him.
No one can introduce you like Pastor Sean Wallace. Amen. We think I'm just going to record his introduction, and every time I stand, praise God. God bless you, sir. Amen. It's offering time. Amen. We ought not get quiet now. It's offering time. And tonight we're going to take one offering, and that will be for our amazing moderator, and certainly to First Lady Dumas as well. I want to congratulate them. Many of you may not know, but they just married one of their daughters off. And I want to congratulate both of them, amen, on such a wonderful, wonderful feat. And so our officers, if we would get ready and prepared, there's going to be one offering, and it will be for our moderator, amen. This is his night, amen. We bless the name of the Lord. One offering, his Cash App is $DUMASFBC. Again, that is $DUMASFBC for our moderator. And also, if you're going to make checks out, you can make them out to him personally. Amen, Dr. Derek Dumas. And we ask that you would be a blessing. We're going to ask if you would get the baskets and let us prepare our offering. I'm going to say a word of prayer. We're going to have some giving music. Amen. Let's give it up for that choir. Amen. We bless God for them tonight. And those of you online, we pray that you would participate as well and be a blessing to our moderator. We thank God. That introduction was very, very important, and it was needed. And Dr. Wallace hit everything on how we feel about our moderator. So we can be a blessing to him tonight. We're asking the cabinet to please give $100. Amen. Everyone in his cabinet, please give at least $100. Amen. Let us look to the Lord. Eternal God, our Father, we thank you for this night. This is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you in spite of the inclement weather, God, that we are here. We thank you for those on site, and we thank you for those online. We thank you now for a spirit of giving, and we want to be a blessing to our moderator in as much as he has been a blessing to many. We pray that you would use him and use this offering to encourage his heart, further his ministry, and be a blessing to he and his family. We ask it all now in the mighty name of Jesus our Christ, and all the hearts and minds said amen. Amen. We're going to ask that you would stand at this time and come from the front to the back again. Cash App is $DUMASFBC, or you can make your check out personally to Pastor Derek Dumas. Amen. Thank you, Dr. Bullock. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given unto thee. All things come. Amen. Thank you. We're going to hear from this amazing music aggregate at this time, after which we will hear the moderator's annual address by the one and only Reverend Dr. Derek Dumas. Amen.
Come on and put your hands together and tell God thank you. thank you, Lord. Everybody tell him thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, tell him thank you. Yeah. Come on and tell him thank you. Yeah. Tell him thank you. Thank you, Lord. Tell him thank you. Thank you, Lord. Tell him thank you. Thank you, Lord. You made a way. I don't know way. Thank you, Lord. Oh. For my.
Praises be to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is alive and well. The songwriter put it perfectly when he said, because he lives, that we can face tomorrow. And I already told you before that I don't know what your tomorrow holds, but I do know who holds tomorrow in the palm of his hands. And I can say with all confidence that everything's gonna be all right as long as we keep holding to God's unchanging hands. And so we are grateful to Pastor Conway Johnson and the Sharon Baptist Church family, to you, my brothers and sisters of the Middlesex Central Baptist Association, to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, I greet you in the name of the one who was, the one who is, and the one who shall forever be, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And somebody taught me a long time ago, that's a good way to greet Christians, and the one who saved us. And so we're grateful. You may be seated. I want to officially open up the 118th Middlesex Central Baptist Association's annual session. We are now open. And we thank God for it, because 118 years is a long time. In the long time. But God has been faithful. God has been faithful. And so we bless his name on tonight. There is a word from the Lord. I really don't want to keep you long at all tonight, but I want to call your attention to a small passage of scripture in the book of Numbers. If you have your Bibles, turn with me to Numbers, the 13th chapter. And I want to read a small passage of scripture, but there is one line that has gripped my attention in the confines of my own praying ground. And I want to lift up that in your hearing. Numbers chapter 13, I'll begin reading at verse number 26. It says, they came back to Moses and Aaron and the whole Israelite community at Kadesh in the desert of Paran. There they reported to them and to the whole assembly and showed them the fruit of the land. They gave Moses this account. We went into the land to which you sent us, and it does flow with milk and honey. Here is its fruit. But the people who live there are powerful, and the cities are fortified and very large. We even saw the descendants of Anak there, the Amalekites, live in the Negev, the Hittites, the Jebusites, the Amorites, live in the hill country, and the Canaanites live near the sea and along the Jordan. Then Caleb silenced the people before Moses and said, we should go up and take possession of the land, for we can certainly do it. But the men who had gone up with him said, we can't attack those people. They are stronger than we are. And they spread among the Israelites a bad report about the land they had explored. They said, the land we explored devours those living in it. All the people we saw there were of great size. We saw the Nephilim there, the descendants of Anak come from Nephilim. We seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Amen. And Caleb silenced the people before Moses and said, we should go up and take possession of the land, for we can certainly do it. My brothers and sisters, just for a few moments, I want to preach from the subject, we can do this. We can do this. You don't have to live long to come to the conclusion that in life, all of us have to deal, or all of us are faced with, both challenges and choices. The challenges we face influence the choices we make. We got to deal with challenges, and we got to make some choices. This is true because life, for all of us, as we trek and trail across the pilgrimage of faith, journeying from where we are to where God would have us to be, life often will put us at a crossroads. The crossroads is a place where a decision has to be made. The crossroad in life is the place where you will either walk by faith according to the dictates and the demands of the divine, or you will retreat in fear and walk by sight according to the distractions and the desires of the world. All of us every now and then are put at a crossroads, a place in life where a decision has to be made. Can I get a witness? You will either walk by faith or you're gonna walk by sight. You will either retreat in fear or you will stand strong by faith. All of us every now and then have some challenges, and all of us are faced with some choices. And when we examine this text, we discover the people of God who find themselves at a crossroads. The record is they are at a pivotal point in their pilgrimage. And God now, they're situated up somewhere on the periphery of the promised land. God had already delivered them up out of the oppressive land of Egypt, from incarceration to emancipation, and now on the brink of the land of their liberation. God had already turned a sea into a sidewalk. God had already fed them with quail by night and manna by morning. God had already broke the yoke of their bondage and enabled them to walk with their head held high. God had already done a mighty work in their lives. And I might as well pause parenthetically. Every now and then, you ought to look back at what God has done. Because when you understand what God has done, you'll understand what God can do. And I don't know about you, but I serve a God who can do anything but fail. He can do exceedingly abundantly above everything that I could ever think and imagine, because he is able. Anybody believe he's able? He's able to do more than I could ever think or imagine. So the people are at a crossroads. God has brought them out, and God is about to bring them in. But you know how some folk are. They can't get on board what God is doing because they begin to doubt God's word. And so the record is, there was some folk in the crowd, in the congregation, who says that, listen, we want to send some spies into the land because we need to get a peek at God's provision. It's not enough just to take God at his word, because God says, I've already given you the land. All I need you to do is have enough faith to go and possess what I've already provided. So the people say, let's send some spies into the land. So God directs Moses, pick some leaders from the tribes and say, you got to pick some new leaders, because some of the older leaders don't have the strength or the stamina to make the 500-mile round trip into the promised land to Rehob through the Negev and back to the desert. So pick some leaders and send them to spy out the land. Yes, spy out the land and bring the report back to us. Record is that they go through the land, and the land was flowing with milk and honey. Because God, when God makes a promise, his promises are true. It was a land flowing with milk and honey. There were big houses there, and there were fortified walls there. There were olive groves and vineyards there. And the record is they, as they made their way back to the desert, to the people, they stopped in the valley of Eshcol, and they got some grapes. And the grapes were so big that they had to put them on a pole and carry them, back to the camp with two people. The Bible says that when they get back to the camp, they got the fruit of the land on their shoulders, and they begin to give Moses and the people a report. And you know how it is. Some in the crowd say, oh yeah, the land, yes indeed, was flowing with milk and honey, and the land was a blessed land, and the land was good for us. But, and there's always a but. There was always a but in the camp. You always have some buts in the congregation. You always have some buts. But the people there are large, and the cities are well secured. Yeah, we even saw the descendants of Anak there. Can I get a witness? The people of God, now the ones that spied out the land, began to give a discouraging report. And they began to not only give a discouraging report to the to Moses, but they also began to give a discouraging report to the people. And what you need to know is that fear is the enemy of faith that will paralyze you, keep you standing still when God's trying to take you forward.
But what I love about it, God always has a witness. God always has somebody in the camp who's willing to stand flat-footed and say, I believe what the Lord said to me. Caleb stands up in the midst of the crowd. He says, we can do this. We can certainly do it. He says, let's go in and take the land because God has promised it to us. And we can do this. That's what Caleb says. God always has a faithful witness who will not cower in fear, but is willing to move forward by faith. Caleb stands up, and we need some Calebs in our church. We need some we can do this people in our association. I'm really tired of people who all they can do is complain and criticize and be in competition with one another. Don't you know we're all on the same team? We all serve the same God. The same God that saved you is the same God that raised me. So here it is. The question I ask Texas, why didn't they go in into the promised land? It cost them 40 years of wandering because they refused to enter into the land that God had provided. The reason, one of the reasons they didn't enter is because they had the grasshopper complex. They had a grasshopper complex. The grasshopper complex is when someone utilizes exaggerated speech, hyperbole, to emphasize a negative perspective about the future. The grasshopper complex is the complex where people, yes, where people see the glass as half empty as opposed to half full. The grasshopper complex is when you see yourself in lieu of what you're confronted with without seeing the reality of who God is and what God has done. Anytime you visualize what's confronting you without visualizing who God is, you are engaging in a grasshopper mentality. The Bible says they went into the land and they saw that the people were large. And when they looked at the people, they saw themselves as grasshoppers in their sight. What a shame that is. You look at an enemy or the opposition and you come back with a negative assessment on yourself. Nobody called you a grasshopper. You called yourself a grasshopper. And let me tell you, the grasshopper complex is alive and well in the church today. You always have some people who, some negative Nellies, who never have anything good to say and always want to complain and criticize. If you're going to move forward by faith, you got to get rid of the grasshopper complex. Well, what did they see? It's amazing how 12 people can see the same thing and have different renditions of what they saw. They saw a fruitful land. They saw fortified cities. And they saw a formidable foe. That's what they saw. Now, if you're going to enter into the promised land, if we're going to get to where God wants us to be, Middlesex Central Baptist Association, you got to understand that promised land living requires promised land mentality. That's what it requires. It requires a promised land mentality that's inclusive, number one, of promised land vision, promised land faith, and promised land power. Look at this one, this one phrase, and I'm done. In essence, what Caleb says is, let's go up because we can do this. That's what he says. The first thing in that text is the word we. If you're going to enter into the realm of new reality, you got to have promised land vision. And the we has a vertical dimension and a horizontal dimension. Now notice, Caleb doesn't say me. He says we. because he understands the importance of relational unity that's going to make the difference as we enter into the realm of new reality. In other words, it's not about me, it's about we. It's about us. It is a team first mentality that puts others before oneself. If you're going to make it to the promised land, you got to have a we in your life, in your vocabulary. It ain't all about you, because God doesn't give everybody everything, but he does give all of us something. And when we come together, when we stand together, when we salute one another, when we pick each other up, when it's all about the team and not about you, God can work a miracle in your life. Can I get a witness? It's the we factor. It's a horizontal dimension, but the we also includes God. Oh my gosh. When I say we can do it, I'm not omitting the reality of who God is. The we is God and me. And me and you. Promised land vision is vision that can see beyond what it sees and is in tune and in touch with the divine reality which is above us. You just don't want to see the problem. You want to make sure you see God, because who you see is greater than what you see. And who you see can enable you to overcome what you see. Going to take promised land vision, because he says we. But it's also going to take promised land faith. It takes courage, but it also takes confidence. Because Caleb says we can do this. He doesn't say we can't do it. He doesn't say we might do it. He says we can do it. Promised land living requires promised land vision, but it also requires promised land faith. And promised land faith is a faith that can embrace the reality of God's truth, even when there's no external evidence that says what God says is going to come to pass. Yeah. Promised land faith says, I am going to apprehend the truth of God's word and apply it to my life through conviction and obedience. You demonstrate that you really believe, not by what you say, but by what you do. Can I get a witness? Faith is about what you do, because faith without works is dead. And can I tell you, you ain't always going to feel like doing what God tells you to do, but Christian discipleship is not based on emotion. Because if you only did what you felt like doing, you wouldn't do anything at all. You got to thank God that faith expresses itself in action. And sometimes you say, well, pastors, you don't know what I'm going through. No, I don't know what you're going through, but God knows what you're going through. I say it all the time. Sometimes faith is both insight and eyesight. When your eyesight fails, you got to learn how to rely on your insight. Your insight is the information you know about God that is true, even when it doesn't square with what you're seeing on the outside world. Can I get a witness? The hardest thing for us to do as Christians is reconcile the word of God and the will of God with what we see in the world. We're going to take promised land faith, but it's also going to take promised land. We can do this. Power. Yeah. Promised land power. God never calls us to a task that we can do in our own power. You ever ask God, why did you call me to this? Why did you lead me down this path? Why am I climbing this mountain? God says, I'm going to call you to a task that's greater than you are, because I got to teach you and deliver you from dysfunctional dependence. Some of us have been growing and we've been doing the same thing the same way for years. And now we become dependent because we got good at ministry. And now we depend more on our personal gifts than we do on our personal God. So God says, in this season of your life, I'm going to orchestrate the circumstances and situations in your life to force you to totally depend on me. And I come to tell you that he is the right one to depend on. Come hell or high water, I'm sticking with God. And I learned a long time ago, don't put your trust in anything but the Lord. Because the Lord is powerful. He's omniscient. He's omnipresent. That means he's everywhere at the same time. He's omnipotent. He can do anything but fail. And so God says in this season of your life, you got to learn how to depend on me. And I don't know about you, I'm glad about that. Because you can trust in the Lord. You can depend on Jesus. He is a reliable resource that will enable us and equip us to do exceedingly abundantly what we could never do in our own power. Lord's trying to take you into your next season. It's going to require people with promised land vision. Promised land, yes, faith. Promised land, power. And when you depend on God's power, you'll be rewarded with promised land provision. Can I get a witness? God makes promises, but he is a promise keeper. Notice, when you're walking with God, God doesn't always give you and I explanations, but he does give us a book full of promises. And when you walk with God, every now and then you got to learn how to lean on his promises. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. That's a promise. I can do all things through Christ who is my strength. That is a promise. I told you I'd never leave you or forsake you. Those are promises. And when I think about the promises of God, I don't know about you, my soul gets happy. I stopped by to tell you, Middlesex Central Baptist Association, that we can do this. We can do it because God can do anything but fail. And the God that's above me is the God that is in me. And the God that is in me is the God that is for me. And if God be for me, there's no devil in hell that can be against me. I stop by to tell you, we can do this because the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When my enemies come upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Somebody say, yeah. Praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. The Lord is good. And if God be for us, we can do this. That's all I want to say. We can do this. Listen to me. I'm so grateful for these brothers right here. This is a team. And if you on any team, if you watch any sports, you know that on a team, everybody got to play their position. But there's no one person that's more significant than the other because we have a team goal in mind. Can I tell you, let me tell you something. We can do this. We can make a difference in our communities. We can make a difference in our churches. We can make a difference in the world because the we is not just me. The we is us. And the we is God. We can do this. God bless you. And may heaven smile upon you. Listen to me. Everybody who's able, please stand. We got somebody on here. Listen to me. Listen. Our association will never be what it could be without us. Each one of you play an important role in the furtherance of the kingdom. A significant role. And I just believe, I really believe this, we're better together. God really didn't create us to exist on islands. Mm-mm. God says, listen, I want to do some things through you. But before I can do some things through you, I got to do some things in you. Yeah, I got to do some things in you. And so we're praying that God would continue to keep his hand on all of us as individuals and all of us collectively, corporately, and as association. Keep your hand on us, God. Deliver and develop us in ways that only you can ways. Let every head bow and every eye close for one moment. God, thank you. Thank you for your word and your people, God. Thank you for reminding us that we can do this. Mm-hmm. It's going to take faith. It's going to take vision. It's going to take power. But you are the reliable resource that we can rely on. And so we thank you. Bless us now. Guide and direct our footsteps. In Jesus' name we pray. We all say together, amen.
Hallelujah. Can we give God the glory for that message? As moderator Duma said, we can do this. We can do this. In church, one of the greatest ways to know that we can do it is to look at what God has already done. You may be seated now. You may be seated. We thank God for this message and for this word. Certainly, as Middlesex Central Baptist Association continues this work, we thank God for the things that he is continuing to do in our midst. And one of the greatest ways to show our faith, one of the greatest ways to show our willingness, is for us to come together. Along those lines, if there be any church here that has not registered for the 2023 year, we implore you to do so. We strongly encourage you to do so. Reverend Nathaniel Bullock, our treasurer, Reverend Bullock, if you wouldn't mind standing. And Sister Martha Turner-Riddick, Sister Turner-Riddick, if you wouldn't mind standing as well, are here to accept your registration for 2023. And if there be anyone here that has not registered, you will be saying that you still have what Dr. Dumas called that grasshopper mentality. Let's put that to the side and say, yes, we can do this. Yes, we will do this. And make sure if you have not sealed your business with them that you see them before you leave today. Amen? Amen. 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 We thank God for them and for their work. But certainly we know that the Lord is working in our midst and that God has still not removed his hand from the Middlesex Central Baptist Association. We know this because MCBA has partnered with Lot Carey this year in support of their anti-trafficking initiative and the Double Dutch Revival. MCBA was a part of the Jumping for Justice Giving Circle, which meant we raised some money. We put on the event in partnership with Fountain Baptist Church, with the General Baptist Convention of New Jersey. And guess what? The result was a resounding $35,000. $35,000. We can do this. That was raised in support of that initiative. We didn't stop there, but MBCA also partnered with the General Baptist Convention of New Jersey in support of their Women in Ministry Summit Initiative. That was a wonderful event. It was taking place at New Brunswick Theological Seminary, where many women in ministry, many sisters, many people who are curious about ministry were able to come together and receive that blessing. And personally, myself, at least one of my ministers went out there and said, Pastor, I thank you for encouraging me to go. It was a blessing to me. We can do this. MCBA also held its 108th semi-annual session at Tabernacle Baptist Church in New Brunswick, New Jersey, where Reverend Ryan Buckland is the pastor. We also held the Congress of Christian Education and had a discussion on death and dying that was led by our Congress of Christian Education President, Reverend Gerald Smith. And the guest panelist was Reverend Donna Owusu-Ansah, who is the new elected pastor of First Baptist Church in Englewood, New Jersey. And God blessed us and allowed us to have a wonderful semi-annual session. We can do this. MCBA is also supporting Mount Olive Baptist Church, which is coming up in Plainfield, New Jersey, where Reverend Eric Wallace is pastor, and he will be hosting a free seminar on collaborating for community service on Saturday, September 30th, 2023. That's from 9:30 to 12 p.m. That's coming up, and we implore everyone to come out and be a part of this blessing. The phase of this church, the time of this church, is partnership. We can't do everything. We don't have all the resources of every organization. But if we partner together, we can get a whole lot done for the kingdom of God. We can do this. MCBA also put together an association choir. Let's give them a round of applause for our association choir. Amen. Led by Minister Marquise Duncan, God bless you, who also comes to us by way of Tabernacle Baptist Church in New Brunswick. And did they not bless our souls on this evening? Amen. Once again, it is proven true. We can do this. And moderator Dr. Dumas was also recently recognized by the General Baptist Convention of New Jersey at their annual recognition breakfast for his work in the General Baptist Convention of New Jersey, for the way that he has supported and banded the people together to be a strong part of GBCNJ. Together, we can do this. And so also, brothers and sisters, MCBA is committed and is working hard in rebuilding and mobilizing our auxiliary ministries for the furtherance of God's kingdom. And to this end, we're asking you to bring your sister, your cousin, your niece, your nephew, those who have a gift for the kingdom, for the men's ministry, for the women's auxiliary, for our ushers, for our nurses, to come together and declare together that we can do this. There is a need for our auxiliaries to be rebuilt, to be strengthened, and to be edified, and it can only be done when we come together. And finally, brothers and sisters, we implore you once again that our General Baptist Convention is coming up, that we're going to have our event that is going to take place the beginning of October. I believe we're beginning on October 7th and going to October 9th. That is going to be hosted at the Fountain Baptist Church in Summit, New Jersey. And wherever Dr. Michael J. Sanders is the pastor and also the president of General Baptist Convention in New Jersey. But Middlesex, do you know where Dr. Sanders calls his home association? You know he's got a home association. You know his home association is none other than Middlesex Central Baptist Association. So what would it look like for our very own president, for Dr. Sanders, to host an event for the whole state and his home association don't show up? So we ought to make sure that we're there and that we're wearing our white to support the home team. Make sure we're wearing our purple and black to support the home team. Because we know that together we can do this, and we're going to be there to support our president. We're going to be there as Middlesex Central Baptist Association, making that one declaration. What? That we can, amen, somebody.
Okay, we are just about ready to depart. I just want to make one correction. The General Baptist Convention of New Jersey's annual session will begin on Friday, October 6th, with a choir concert. And our MCBA choir, I can't wait, is going to be performing at that event on Friday, October 6th. And then it will continue for on Saturday. There's a pastor's symposium. And then on Sunday, our convention president, the Reverend Dr. J. Michael Sanders, will give his state annual address. And I want you to know, he's asked the Middlesex Central Baptist Association to host that event that will take place at Fountain Baptist Church. You know what that means? That means we need to see everybody there. I need to see ushers there. I need to see pastors and preachers there. I need to see Middlesex there in full strength on the 8th, which is that Sunday evening, for our president's annual address. Again, let me thank you for your support. Thank you for continuing to be faithful in your stewardship and your support of this association. And let me say this, I look forward. Next year is going to be a rebuilding year. Okay, it's going to be a rebuilding year. Just buckle up your seatbelts. We're going to do some things next year in order to enable us to be and become all that God would have us to be. So I'm looking forward to that. Again, I want to thank this cabinet here, this leadership team, because that's what it is. It is a team. Gifted pastors all over the state of New Jersey. I'm proud of all of them, and I'm grateful that God has allowed me to be a part of this team. Again, I want to thank people here from First Baptist Church who are here, my church family, the best church on this side of the East Coast. Don't look at me like that, Jordan. Don't look at me like that. No, I'm thankful. I'm grateful for their faithfulness and stewardship. And then I want to thank my wife, who's with me here on tonight, who is faithful and dedicated in her support of me. We are ready to depart. Let's stand. I think so. Oh, I think there's one presentation. Who? Is there a presentation that want to be given to one of the women? Okay. I'm sorry. My bad. Let us look to the Lord. Now unto him who is able to keep us all from falling and to present us all faultless before his throne with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be majesty, dominion, power, and glory, henceforth and forevermore. Let all God's people say amen. Stay right here for a picture. You may be dismissed. Amen. I'm sorry. I want to get a picture.
Greetings, family. It is with great excitement that we announce the 10-20-30 celebration honoring our beloved pastor, Conway Cornelius Johnson, Jr. First, we celebrate that he has been the pastor of the Sharon Baptist Church for the last 10 years. Second, we celebrate 20 years of pastoral leadership. And third, we celebrate 30 years of preaching the gospel of our Lord. The 10-20-30 celebration will be at the Heldrich Hotel on Saturday, October 21st, 6 p.m., right here in New Brunswick. The cost is $125 per person. All tickets must be paid in full by Sunday, October 1st. We want everyone who has been impacted by his ministry to be a part of this historical celebration. We will see you there. Truth and the light, no one gets to the Father except that he comes through me. Yeah. So let not mercy.